speaking what is in our heart. The parable in Matthew chapter 21 verses 28 through 32 concerning the two sons working in the vineyard tells us more about the two sons than the father. We know that the first son tells his father that he will not go into the vineyard, but later he changes his mind and goes. We know that the second son says that he is on his way to the vineyard, but he never shows up. The only thing we know about the father is that he asks each of his sons to work in the vineyard. This lack of information is intentional. It makes the father of the parable like us. We are not able to control what other people say or do. Like the father in the parable, we are only able to say what is in our heart and then let others respond. We can tell them, this is important to me. This is what I want. But people are free to hear our desires or ignore them. We might have a deep desire that our son or daughter will live a life of service, caring for other people. All we can do is share that such values are important to us. Our daughter might say, of course, Dad, I know what that means to you. But later we watch as she builds her life only for her own success and comfort. Our son may respond, back off, Mom, I'm looking to make money. But one day we discover that he spends time on the weekends at a soup kitchen and has joined a group working for economic justice. Our friends may be going through difficult times, so we say, are things okay with you? Is there anything I can do to help? One friend may respond, we are close. If anything is wrong, you will be the first to know. But time passes and he tells you nothing. Another friend might say, there are issues, but I have to keep some things to myself. Then later, she contacts us and trusts us enough to share her concerns. We cannot control another person. Surprisingly, this gives us freedom. Paul describes such freedom in Philippians chapter 1, verse 20c through 24 and 27a. He is not sure whether it is better for him to live or die. But he tells the Philippians, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, life is Christ and death is gain. Christ can be served either by our living or our dying. The only important thing is that we live in him. As long as we speak what is in our heart with honesty and love, we have done what Christ expects us to do. What others choose is not our responsibility. Like the father in the parable, we have spoken what we believe. Then it is time to place others and their responses into God's hands. For more stories, please visit our website, www.pamphletstoinspire.com.